Hello friends, welcome to my channel. The topic to be covered in this video lecture is the mutual inductance. Okay. So what is mutual inductance? Okay. So mutual, it means we need two coils. That's why between the two coil is defined as the property of the coil due to which it opposes the change of current in other coil. Okay. So it means it opposes the change of the current in other coils. So basically, what do we need in the for mutual induction? The first thing is that we need two coil. Okay, we need two coil. The second thing is that it depends on the geometry of the coil. So it depends on the geometry of the coil. Then also it depends, depends on the geometry of the coil. It also depends on the orientation. Orientation of the coils. Okay. So how it depends on the geometry, how it depends on the orientation, we are going to describe now. So you see that these are my two coils. Suppose assuming this is my coil number 1 and this is my coil number 2. Okay. So what happened? You see in that coil, this is my source is there and there is a galvanometer. So first, when we switch on the key, suppose this is my key. So when we switch on the key, what happened? It means my current is increasing from 0 to any value. Okay, so just I am writing it here like this. So the first step is that key on, and in this is in coil 1. Then what happened? When you switch on the key, then current increases from 0 to I at coil 1. So I think you understood now. First, when you switch on the key in the coil 1, then it means the current starts increasing from 0 to at any values of I. Then next, what happens when the current increases? It means the flux increases. Increases in coil 1. So when the current increases, okay, then it means my flux is increases in coil 1. Then next is that flux, it means flux, when the flux is increasing in coil 1, it means it affects the flux of the coils too. So I can say that flux increase in coil 2 also. So I think you understand. First we switch on the key in coil 1, then when we switch on the key, then it means my current starts increasing from 0 to any value at coil 1. Then my flux increases. So when the current increases, we know that when the current increases, then my magnetic flux is increases. So magnetic flux is increased at coil 1. So due to the effect of magnetic flux in coil 1, it also affects the magnetic flux of the coil 2. Okay. So flux increases in coil 2 also. So due to the increasing flux of the coil 2, what happened in the next? Induced EMF produced in which coil? In coil 2. Because we know that when there is a change in flux, so due to the change in flux, there is a magnetic, it means induced EMF is there. So now induced EMF is produced in coil 2. So when induced EMF is there, then it means induced current in coil 2. So So when the induced current is there, then we can get some deflection in the galvanometer. So now I think you understood. First I switch on the key in the coil 1, then when I switch on the key in the coil 1, what happened? My current starts increasing from 0 to at I, it means 0 to any value. So due to the increase in the current, my flux starts increasing. Okay, my flux starts increasing into that direction, and this flux also affect in coil 2. And when the flux increasing, it means my induced EMF is also increasing. So it means induced EMF produced in coil 2, and due to the induced EMF, my induced current in the coil 1. So that thing I think you understand. So we know that according to the Faraday's law, that my induced current is increasing, that it tries to oppose the change in the flux. So it opposes the change in flux. So you understand what is the main that concept behind the mutual induction. So mutual induction, it means that we need two coils. Okay, so you need two coils. The second thing is depends on the geometry of the coil. So basically, why it depends on the geometry? Suppose one of my coil has size is very high, and the size of the second coil is very small, then we can't get the proper result. Okay, that's why it depends on the geometry. Then also it depends on the orientation of the coil. Suppose in one case maybe my coil is in this direction and maybe like this direction, then you see there is the opposite orientation is not proper. So in that case also we are not getting the proper result using that mutual induction. So the main thing is that it depends on the geometry of the coil, and it also depends on the orientation of the coil. Then when we get the two coil, then we can switch on the key. So after switch on the key, it means current starts flowing like this. So it starts flowing from 0 to at I means at any value. Then when the current is increased, it means it increases the magnetic flux. So that magnetic flux also produced in the coil 2, and this magnetic flux create the induced EMF in the coil 2, and this induced EMF produce the induced current in coil 2. Then according to the Faraday's law, we know that when my current is increases, then it opposes the change in the flux. So now how we write this mutual induction mathematically. So we know that from our the phi equal to m I. Okay, so what is this m? So m, we know that this is the coefficient of mutual induction. So we can write it just like this. Suppose the phi 2 proportional to I1. So what 2? 2 means my second coil, and I my first coil. So first coil means it is my source. I1 current is there, and then I get the flux in the coil 2. So that's why phi 2 directly proportional to phi 1. Then we can write it just like this. Phi 2 equal to m I1. So that m is the coefficient of mutual induction. Now from Faraday's law, we know that our E equal to minus d phi by dt. Okay, so now we can write what is the value of my phi. So we can write it is just phi 2. So what is the value of my phi? My phi is m I. So we can write it like this, minus m d I by dt. So this E equal to minus m d I by dt is my formula for mutual induction. Okay, So I think now you understand what is the meaning of that mutual induction, how we get that numerical formula from mutual induction, and what is the main concept behind this mutual induction. So thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe my channel to get the more updates.